You just might end up making the world a better place. But first, you have to discover who you are and what you can learn from others. To do that, you have to seek out teachers and mentors who will help you identify your goals and challenge you to go after them. Before you can do that, you have to find a community that welcomes and supports you. A place where you can learn, a place where you can thrive. Before you can do that, you must have motivation and desire to improve your mind, your soul, your circumstances. To ignite that desire, you must find your potential. We'll help you discover your potential once you discover us. Elmhurst University.
fans, please welcome to the field the visiting Adrian College Bulldogs. Blue Jay fans, get on your feet and welcome your Elmhurst University Blue Jays!
Adrian, you are the visiting team. The head side is a helmet, tails is a skyline. I'm going to flip it, let it hit the ground. What's your call? Tails is called. It is tails, you've won. Adrian has won the toss and is deferred to the second half. You want the ball? Which way do you want to kick? You're kicking.
Decisions.
Elmhurst will receive.
Yep. Ready? Before we begin, Elmhurst University Athletics would like to honor the memory of Dylan Moran, a junior men's cross-country student athlete who tragically passed away on Wednesday. Moran, an exercise science major at Elmhurst, was a beloved son, brother, and member of the Blue Jay community. Please keep Dylan's friends and family in your thoughts and prayers. At this time, we please pause for a moment of silence in memory of Dylan. Thank you. Elmhurst University Athletics would also like to honor the memory of Mark Kruger, longtime play-by-play announcer for Blue Jay Athletics, who passed away in early August. Kruger passionately served as the voice of the Blue Jays for over 12 years, lending his voice to Elmhurst football, volleyball, men's and women's basketball, and men's and women's lacrosse contests. Please keep Mark's friends and family in your thoughts and prayers. At this time, please pause for a moment of silence in memory of Mark Krueger. Thank you. Fans, at this time, we ask that you please stand if you are willing and able. Please remove your hats, face the flag for the playing of our national anthem.
It's college football Division III style as this afternoon we kick off the 2023 football season here at Elmhurst University as the Adrian Bulldogs from Adrian, Michigan make the trek down to take on the Blue Jays here at Langhorst. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Bob Brunell. Happy to be on hand for this afternoon's action, and should be a good ball game between these two clubs. One an upstart and one a little bit more enshrined with the winning ways a year ago, as Adrian had compiled a 6-4 mark a year ago, 3-3 in league play, and they're a member of the Michigan Intercollegiate Athletic Association, while the Blue Jays had a difficult season a year ago, and they're a member of the CCIW conference and has been for years, and they'd like to get things off on the right hand here this afternoon. Beautiful day for football. It's going to be a warm one, however. The temperatures are going to approach and maybe exceed the 90-degree mark. There's a nice little breeze coming this afternoon out of the southwest and is bringing a little bit of a breeze into the stadium, but otherwise it's going to be rather warm. The Adrian Bulldogs have won the toss, and they will defer until the second half. Elmhurst will receive the football, and we're about ready to get this game underway. The kicker for Adrian is Alec Milley, and he's teeing that ball up at the 40-yard line. Xander and Pollock are back deep for the Blue Jays in their powder blue uniforms with darker blue numerals, while Adrian in the road traveling white uniforms with black trim, black helmets. The Blue Jays helmets are that powder blue as well. And the 23 season is underway here at Langhorst Field. Ball taken at the 5, 10, 15, the 20, up to the 30. Across the 30 to about the 32 or 33 yard line is the return man for the Blue Jays. And so it'll be first down and 10 yards to go with the ball about the 32 or 33 yard line.
Blue Jays start first and 10 at their 32 yard line.
So at quarterback for the Blue Jays will be Andre Acosta, 6'1", 215 pounds sophomore. And his running back is Samson Xander, 5'9", 180, a sophomore. They work from the spread formation. The give is to the first back through, and that is Xander. And Xander does not get even back to the line of scrimmage. There'll be a slight loss on the play of a couple. Let's call it second down and eight.
Loss of 2 on the play.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. Again, second down. Excuse me, I said second eight. Second down and 12 to go. The return man on the kickoff was Adrian Pollock for the Blue Jays. So we've got trips out to the left side, a single receiver, a lone receiver to the right side. And Acosta fakes to the Xander and keeps it. And gets back to maybe the original line of scrimmage. Maybe he got a yard on the play for a gain. Let's see where they mark it. They're going to mark it at the 33. So give him a gain of a yard. So now it's going to be
gain of 4 on the play.
Third down and about 10 to go. Correction, a gain of 4 yards on the play. So the first third down conversion opportunity for the Blue Jays here this afternoon as well as this season. And a give up to the middle to Xander. Xander gets up across the 40 to the 45-yard line, maybe the 46-yard line. And a first down, the first one for the Blue Jays here this afternoon. Tackle made by Ashmon for Adrian. So it's first down, 10 yards to go for the Blue Jays. So we've got receivers deployed to either side. Again, the single back offense. There's a slot man to the right. Fakes the handoff, and the pass comes out here to Cockrell. Cockrell gets up maybe the 45. And we've got a whistle stopping play. And we'll look to the official in the middle of the field.
The clock did not run on the last sequence. Please reset the clock to 12:58.
So we're going to reset the clock here.
It will start on my signal.
So we're going to replay that down.
12:58. Thank you.
So it looks like we're going to do first down and 10 to go again. From the 46 of the Blue Jays. Xander. No, they fake it to Xander. They throw down the field here. Intended for the
Desmore,
the wide receiver, but it goes incomplete. It'll be second down. So they got a good freeze on the linebackers there with the fake by Acosta to Xander, but they could not connect with the wideout, Desmore. Second down and 10, make that third down and 10. Ball marked at the Bulldog 46-yard line. Acosta. From the gun, cuts it up, runs up across midfield and down into Bulldog territory at the 46-yard line. Gain of about 8 yards, give or take.
Petro with credit for that tackle. 2 yards short of the first down.
Tackle by Petro, the defensive tackle. First fourth down facing the Blue Jays here this afternoon. And it looks like they might be going for it. They give it to the back coming through and bursting up the middle.
First down yardage for the Blue Jays.
Ball carrier was Pollock.
Pollock was the ball carrier for the Blue Jays.
He gets the first down, the Blue Jays second on this drive. So now it's first down, 10 yards to go for Elmhurst at the Adrian 41. Again, receivers deployed to either side. Deliberate snap, Acosta to Xander. Xander wraps his hands squarely around the football and maybe gets a yard.
Leverett with the tackle.
Leverett makes the tackle for the Adrian defense.
No gain on the play.
Virtually no gain on that play. Second down, 10 yards to go for the Blue Jays. The play gets signaled in from Coach Murray. Murray in his first season here at the helm of Elmhurst University. Again, from the pistol offense is Acosta. Drops back to pass, throws over the middle. Has Desmore. Desmore down to the 25. He gets to the 25-yard line.
First down for the Blue Jays.
Correction, not Desmore. That was Parker who made the catch. Another first down for the Blue Jays on the play. Their third. First down and 10 yards to go for Elmhurst. They're at the Bulldog 24. We've got a slot man to the left this side. Twin receivers right, a single receiver to the left. Desmore goes in motion right to left and then comes back left to right. Fakes the handoff, and Acosta's going to get wrapped up and sacked.
Down for a loss.
Loss back to the 31. He actually went back to the 33, but forward progress will bring him to the 31.
Broom and Smith with the tackle.
Smith in on the tackle for one for Adrian. So the loss again back to the 31-yard line. Make it second down about 17 yards to go. Pollock in the backfield to spell Xander for Elmhurst. Twin receivers to the right. We've got a lone receiver out here to the left. That's Masco. They throw out here to Masco. He bobbles the ball but then corrals it and brings it in inside the 25 to about the 23-yard line.
Pickens with the tackle.
Tackle is made by the defense for Adrian. So that ball will be marked, again, inside the 25-yard line, down about the 23. And with that mark, it would be about an 8-yard gain on the play. Third and nine from the 23. This is Pollock. He's going to try the right side. Then he cuts it up over right tackle inside
the
20 and lands down inside the 18-yard line, maybe the 17. Well, they're going to give him better than that. They're going to give him the 16. So a nice run on that play. So at the 16, about a 9-yard pickup. And more than enough for the first down. 8:12 remaining here in the opening quarter. We have no score here on opening day 2023 at Langhorst Field. But Elmhurst is driving. We've got twins to the left. Singleton deployed to the right. Tight end in motion. Hand off to Pollock. He goes right, cuts it back left. Runs into a stack at about the 15-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Yeah. Now they're saying the ball is loose, and it goes to the turf. Let's wait for the official to indicate, yes, the ball has been fumbled
short
and it has been turned
over. Over on down.
So now Adrian takes over. Correction, they take over on downs. It wasn't a fumble. It looked like there might have been a loose ball there, but they just take over on downs, so first down and 10 yards to go for Adrian. And they'll start from their own 15-yard line. Their quarterback is Brady Raymond. Their running back is Sal Paterno, also from the pistol. And Brady takes and gives it to Paterno.
Paterno, the ball carrier.
Paterno gets the 19. Give him a gain of maybe 4 yards on the play. Let's call it second down and
gain
6.
Gain of 4 on the play.
So this is the first offensive go-round now for the Bulldogs. They deploy receivers left and right, single receivers. They've got a slot to the left side. Again, Paterno. He tried to go right, then he cut it back left, but there's nothing there.
Left by a host of Blue Jays.
He may have lost a yard or so on the play.
Masco and Gable get credit for the tackle.
Masco and Gable make the tackle for the Elmhurst defense. Bryce Gable, the linebacker, and Jake Masco, the inside linebacker. So it's 3rd down and 7 for the Bulldogs, working from their own 18-yard line. Raymond on the keeper, running up the middle, then he cuts it outside.
Raymond, the ball carrier.
Gets up to the 25. And they're going to move the chains.
I mean, it's
their first down of the season. First down and 10 yards to go as they pick up a total of 7 yards on the play. 6.5 minutes remaining, opening quarter. We have no score. So let's see what the offensive coach Deer for the Adrian Ball Club has in mind. The southpaw quarterback throws out in the flat.
Pass complete to Kolski.
And the catch is made out there to
Perillo with the tackle.
Kolski made the catch.
Then Kolski.
Pick up of 6 on the play. 2nd down and 4 yards to go for the Bulldogs. Bulldogs are going from west to east here at Langhorst Field. Raymond takes the snap. Again, Paterno. He gets up near the 35-yard line. Make it the 36-yard line after gain of 4. Andre Williams, along with Harris, for the defense for Adrian.
First down yardage on that.
Enough for the first down. So it's 1st down and 10 yards to go for the Adrian Bulldogs. The ball is at their own 36-yard line. Receivers left and right. And the handoff to the back this time. This is Anthony Greer, the second running back for the Adrian Ball Club. And Greer gets the ball up across the 40 to about the 43-yard line.
Hunt with the
7-yard pickup on the play. So it would be 2nd down and about 3 yards to go for the Bulldogs. Greer remains in the backfield.
7 on that run.
Wide receiver coming out, Braden Jewell for the Bulldogs out here in the flat. Second back through. This is Greer. And he was submarined down, but didn't get down on the ground, so he kept moving.
The ball carrier.
And he gets out across the 45 to about the 47. So Greer makes
that
first down yardage as he picked up a total of about 4 yards on the play. 1st down and 10 yards to go. Approaching the 4-minute mark remaining here in the first quarter. We still have no score. Ball is on the right hash for the Bulldogs. Twin receivers deployed to the left side. Raymond rolls left, Paterno blocking for him. Raymond's going to keep it, 45, up to midfield, across the midfield
Raymond
strike,
the ball carrier.
Into Elmhurst territory to 48-yard line. Pickup of about 5 yards in the play. Second down and
Masco
5.
Masco there with the stop for Elmhurst.
Masco made the tackle for the Blue Jays. 2nd down and 5. First time the Bulldogs have gotten into Blue Jay territory. This time they deploy twin receivers to the right side. There's a slot on the right side as well. They fake the... Oh, that is intercepted. The pass is intercepted and running it in to the house for the touchdown.
Touchdown is Elmhurst.
Defender for Elmhurst, Bryce Gable, the linebacker. Raymond raised up for the quick pass over the middle, and Johnny on the spot was the, again, the defender for the Elmhurst Blue Jays, Bryce Gable, and the ball was on the 48-yard line, so 52-yard return to the house for the touchdown, and the score is 6-0 Elmhurst. It was, what a pleasant surprise. It was like, Gable looked up and, what do I have? I've got a touchdown. Extra point attempt forthcoming here.
McCarville's
kick is up.
And good.
Kick is good.
306
remaining in the first quarter. Our score from Langhorst. Elmhurst 7, Adrian nothing. As we return to Langhorst Field, and the Blue Jays, after the 52-yard interception for a touchdown by Gable, find themselves with a 7-0 lead, and
the
Blue Jays are kicking off to restart the game, and Adrian will come back on offense once again here with their second possession of the game. What a heads-up play by Gable to pick up that short pass just over the line of defenders.
On the kicking team. Penalties accepted and will be enforced 5 yards from the previous spot. Re-kick the ball.
Penalty on Elmhurst on the kickoff. And so they're going to make the Blue Jays re-kick it as a result. So it was a 5-yard infraction. So now the Blue Jays will be kicking off from their own 30-yard line.
To re-kick from the 30.
As a result, Malachi Correa will do the honors here for
Thomas and Pipkins back deep for the
Blue Jays.
Correa to kick it away for Elmhurst. Line drive. Pipkins on the return from the 21.
Pipkins on the return for the Bulldogs. Oh, from the 21. He
Pipkins
gets all the way up
midfield.
Across midfield into Bluebird territory. Excuse me, Blue Jay territory at the 49. So Adrian starts this drive in Blue Jay territory at the 49-yard line.
Zafaro gets credit for that tackle for Elmhurst. Adrian starts first and 10 at the Elmhurst 49.
By the 30-yard return on the play for Pipkins. So now the Bulldogs will see what they can do with it with 2:58 remaining here in the opening quarter. Raymond from the pistol, again paternal, looking for somewhere to go, and there's nowhere to go.
Paterno, the ball carrier.
He fell
Harris
forward
first for the Blue Jays.
And getting there first for the Blue Jays was Justin Harris, defensive tackle. Didn't look like he gained anything on the play, but he did fall forward for two. Second down and 8 yards to go at the 47-yard line. So we've got receivers left and right. We've got twin receivers to the right side, a lone receiver to the left. Raymond in the gun, pitches out to the left, and he's got his receiver out there. And he got it out there to Cecilar.
West with the tackle.
To the 41, pickup of about six. West with the tackle. It'll be third and 2 yards to go at the 41-yard line. So Adrian starting a drive here. They got a great return of the kickoff. And they're now in Blue Jay territory as they work again from the 41. Brady, and again, the running back, Paterno, went right, then came back left.
With the tackle.
No gain.
Fourth down facing the Bulldogs.
And the both teams are substituting pretty freely here, trying to keep everybody fresh on a warm afternoon in Elmhurst, Illinois. Twin receivers to the right side. Again from the pistol or the shotgun, if you will. Paterno and Raymond. Raymond keeps it this time. Paterno blocking in front of him.
The ball carrier.
Across the 35-yard line. Down across the 30.
First down yardage for Adrian.
No, they're going to give him the 31. So 10-yard gain on the play. First down and 10 yards to go for the Bulldogs as we're under 1 minute remaining here in the first quarter. Our score, Elmhurst 7, Adrian nothing, but Adrian is driving. Pagel left. Raymond drops back to pass. Looks, Cox tucks it under and runs with it. It gets down to around the 15-yard line. There's a fumble on the play. And it looks like, let's wait for the official. Elmhurst thinks they have it. They do. Elmhurst recovers.
Reeves with the fumble recovery for the Blue Jays. Elmhurst to start first and 10 at their 25.
Chris Reeves got the fumble recovery. Thank you, Jack. So first down, 10 yards to go for the Blue Jays as they now have possession once again. And they'll be working from their own 25-yard line. They'll be going from east to west on this drive. We've got time for one more play remaining here in this, the first quarter. Back in motion. Hand off to Xander right up the middle. He gets a little bit of yardage. He actually went over right tackle this time to the 28. Pickup of three.
Bidwell with the stop.
It'll be second down and 7. Bidwell with the stop for the Bulldogs.
And
that'll be the end of the first quarter. Our score here from Langhorst Field. Elmhurst 7, Adrian nothing.
You just might end up making the world a better place. But first, you have to discover who you are and what you can learn from others. To do that, you have to seek out teachers and mentors who will help you identify your goals and challenge you to go after them. Before you can do that, you have to find a community that welcomes and supports you. A place where you can learn, a place where you can thrive. Before you can do that, you must have motivation and desire to improve your mind, your soul, your circumstances. To ignite that desire, you must find your potential. We'll help you discover your potential once you discover us. Elmhurst University.
As we return, second quarter of action here from Langhorst Field on the campus of Elmhurst University. And the Blue Jays have a 7-0 lead in a football, excuse me. But as they try to snap this ball, attempted to snap there, excuse me, again.
Second down.
They jumped offside, so there'll be a 5-yard walk-off. It'll be second down. So it'll be second down, 11 yards to go from the 29-yard line. So the Blue Jays deploy receivers to the right this time. Two of them in number. Acosta, the give to Zander. Zander works over left guard. Had a little bit of running room, but that hole eventually closed. And a host of tacklers there for the
gain of one on the play.
Bulldog defense, a gain of 1 yard. Second down. Make it third down and 9 from about the 26-yard line. So third down here. Let's see if the Blue Jays can convert. The pass comes out here in the flat. Catch is made by McCarville
near side.
At the 35.
First down.
Pick up 9 yards on the play. It'll be first down. First down for the Blue Jays. First and 10 for the powder blue clad Blue Jays on the floor below. By the way, we failed to mention we've got a brand new stadium floor here at Elmhurst. Beautiful. They just finished it just recently. So great surface within which to play. Acosta fakes. Now he gives the ball out here to the receiver. And the
Anderson.
Pass was caught by R.J. Anderson, the tight end. He's a big one. 6'4", 240, a senior from Algonquin High School.
Gain of 8 on the play.
Gain of 8. So it's second down and 2 yards to go. I always like second and 2. I think that's a great passing down. Let's see if Coach Murray agrees. Twin receivers left side, slot left side as well. Handoff, Zander, there's nowhere to go.
Zander met in the backfield.
Nowhere to go. He lost a yard on the play.
Bidwell there first for the Bulldogs. Loss of 1 on the play.
Loss of 1, make it 3rd and 3. 3rd and 3 to go. Still not a bad passing situation as Holtke checks out of the Elmhurst lineup, and coming back in is Anderson after he got a breather after that last reception a moment ago. 3rd down, 3 yards to go for the Blue Jays. From their own 43. Acosta fakes the pass, tucks it under, runs with it,
Acosta
slides down,
first down,
just shy of the 50, let's call it the 49. Gain of 6 on the play. Good enough for another Blue Jay first down. So it's first down and 10 yards to go from the Blue Jay 49. They're knocking on the Bulldog territorial door. Their intent is to do just that, to get through that door. Slot right, twin receivers to the left side. Acosta from the pistol, hands off to Pollock. Pollock round left end, negotiates the 45-yard line. They're going to give him the 46-yard line.
Gain of five on the play.
Give him a gain of five.
Thomas gets credit for the tackle.
Thomas makes the tackle for the defense. So it's going to be second down, 6 yards to go. The ball now at the Bulldog 47. I know on the high school level, a week ago when I saw a high school game, they did take a water break. We haven't done that here today. I don't know if that is forthcoming or not. Again, Acosta from the pistol. Fakes the handoff. Throws downfield. Pass is broken up.
Pass intended for Cockrell.
Intended for Cockrell. And he couldn't come up with the reception.
Pickens with the breakup.
Pickens with the defense. It's called third and six from the 47. Costa comes over close to Coach Murray to get play calls. They've got the play, so here we go. Costa throws to Pollock.
To Pollock.
40.
Ashman with the tackle. Punting unit comes on the field for Elmhurst.
Not much. So the punting unit will come on for the Blue Jays. First time the Blue Jays have punted here today.
Back deep for the Bulldogs.
Nick Mullett will kick it away for Elmhurst.
Mullett to kick it away.
They said Carey. Kick off, and Mullett gets a nice kick off. Goes out of bounds.
At the 12.
About the 12. So nice kick by Mullett.
First and 10.
And the Bulldogs will take over from there and work. First down and 10 yards to go. So unfortunately, the Blue Jays were unable to capitalize on that fumble recovery. So now it'll be Adrian football and see what they can do with the ball, working now from their own 12-yard line. So they're up against their goal line here. Let's see what they can do to get away from it. Opening weekend of football here at Elmhurst University, as it is many colleges across the country. Here's a run right up the middle to about the 20.
Paterno
was the ball carrier.
Out to the 20.
Picks up about 8 yards on the play. It'll be second down and two after that run right up the middle. Nice run, kept his legs churning.
Carrillo gets credit for the tackle.
Carrillo gets credit for the tackle. So we've got Carrillo and Jewell split out wide to the right and left. And the ball
carrier again.
Carried again by Paterno up across the 25 to about the 27-yard line.
Carrillo there for the Blue Jays along with Charles Scott.
Another nice run by Paterno again, blasting his way up the middle. Give him 8 yards on the carry. First and 10 is the call for the Bulldogs from the 28-yard line. Lone receivers left and right. And this is the second ball carrier through. And the second string ball carrier is Greer. And Greer crosses the 50 down to the 40-yard line.
Laylighter with the tackle, along with Scott.
About a 34-yard pickup on the play for the first down. First down and 10 yards to go for Adrian. In the Blue Jay territory. 9:34 remaining first half, the score. Elmhurst 7, Adrian Bethel.
Paterno, the ball carrier.
And Paterno comes back into the lineup and carries the ball and advances it down into inside the 40 down to about the 37-yard line. So we got second and about three to go from the 37 after that nice run by Greer. Brady thought about passing, now tucks it under. Flag drawn.
Penalty flag on the play. Raymond, the ball carrier.
Raymond gets down to about the 30. But there is a flag on the play.
Holding. Number 56 on the offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. Still second down.
Holding is the call. Whistled against the center, Isaiah Simon. So that gain will be nullified. And the ball will come back to the 48-yard line. So second down, 13 yards to go from the Elmhurst 48. Raymond gives it to Greer, and he has nowhere to go.
Greer, the ball carrier, met in the backfield.
Forward progress to the line of scrimmage.
The lay ladder was there for Elmhurst.
So, lay ladder was there for the Blue Jays to make the stop. So now we're looking at third down, 13 yards to go. The ball remains right in that 47 to 48 yard territory. Adrian. Raymond gets the call. Throws out here in the flat. He's got a man. The reception's made.
Raymond
and
pass complete.
He's gang tackled down.
Caught by Poirier.
But not before the catch is made.
Carrillo there for the Blue Jays. Along
Carrillo made the tackle.
Down facing the Bulldogs. Pollock going back deep for Elmhurst.
Poirier was the receiver.
Back there by Hopke.
Poirier made the reception for the Bulldogs. So it's going to be fourth and 13. And kicking it away for Adrian will be Millie, I do believe. Excuse me, LaFada. Millie's the kicker. Here's the snap. The boot bounces down about the 17 on a line drive. The deep men for Elmhurst let it roll down to the 5-yard line where the Blue Jays will have the ball first down and 10 yards to go. 7 minutes, 1 second left in the first half. Our score, Elmhurst 7 and Adrian nothing. As we return to action, the Blue Jays on the attack, first down and 10
Pollock,
yards to go.
The ball carrier brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
They tried the left side there.
And Bidwell there, a loss first on the play. For the Bulldogs. Loss of two on the play.
Loss of two. Pollock was the ball carrier for Elmhurst. Second down and 12. 6.5 minutes remaining until halftime, with Elmhurst leading 7-0. It's been a good ball game thus far. A defensive battle, if you will. Receivers left and right. Costa, we've got some movement.
Penalty flag on the play.
Penalty marker down.
False start.
False start.
Number one on the offense. Half the distance to the goal.
Called against Masco. By the way, our officials today, our referee is Jack Shanahan. The headline judge is Michael Kurtz. The line judge is Bob Ciola. The side judge is Ken Kessler. The field judge is Steve Hanacki. And the back judge is John Nash. Our officials calling the game today here at Elmhurst. Second down and 12 now. Acosta. And we've got another penalty marker down. And again.
Penalty flag on the play.
It could be another.
False start.
False start, it is.
54 on the offense. After distance to the goal, still second down.
Whistled against the guard, Larson Lovelace for Elmhurst. So they're inside the 1 yard line. We've got about second and 13 to go. The Blue Jays need something here. Let's see what Coach Muller calls here. Now he's going to call a timeout to reset his troops.
Timeout.
And this is an important call when you're inside your own 1 yard line. So they're going to have to take a look at it and talk it over from here.
Yeah, the play clock was correct.
And we're back. Elmhurst trying to get away from their own end zone. Second down and 14, it's inside the 1 yard line. They're gonna pass all the way downfield and send it down here for
McCarville.
Wide receiver
Raymond with the coverage.
McCarville, and almost picked off.
Correction.
Great
Thomas
defensive coverage,
with the
coverage by Andrew Thomas, the cornerback. It falls incomplete. Third down and 14 inside the one. So let's see where we go from here. Again, Elmhurst, let's call it the one, their own one. Treacherous situation. Xander.
Pollock, the ball carrier.
Correction. Pollock, the ball carrier.
Gain of three on the play.
Picks up about three. It'll be fourth down and about 11 to go for the first down. And it looks like. Oops. It looks like. A punt is in order. And they're going to kick it away.
Thomas back deep for the Bulldogs.
Thomas back in single safety for Adrian.
Mullet to kick it away.
He's at the Elmhurst 42. Mullet kicks it away. 35, 30, 25, 22. And then he's tattooed. At the 22.
Charles Scott with that tackle for the Blue Jays.
Charles Scott.
Thomas on the return.
Made a nice tackle, but not before Adrian advances the football.
Adrian to
down
start
to,
first
they're
going to
get the 21. The
21-yard line.
First down and 10 yards to go from the 21. A little bit of a cloud came over here just a little bit. Makes it a little bit cooler. 4:15 remaining here in the first half. 7-0 Elmhurst. Here we go. Up the middle.
Paterno, the ball
two
carrier.
Turnovers and a... And the game
the
for
tackle.
Adrian. Ball up to about the 15-yard line. After a
seven on that last
a
run.
7-yard gain, second and three. Paterno across the
ball carrier.
15 to the 14.
Met behind the line of scrimmage.
Met at the 13.
Gable with the tackle.
Gable makes the tackle for the Blue Jays on the play. Forward progress didn't count here. There's a loss on the play. So we're looking at, what, third and about three to go. They're going to make it third and two from the 13. Raymond.
Raymond, the ball carrier.
Is the ball carrier. He's still got the ball. A rugby scrum down inside the 10.
First down yardage for the Bulldogs.
Near this 7. First down yardage for Elmhurst. So it'll be first and goal from the 7-yard line. First and goal from the 7 as the Bulldogs are in the red zone for the first time in this game with 2:45 remaining here in the first half. 7-0 Elmhurst, but Adrian threatening. Just a single receiver to the right side, Paterno. Went up the middle, there was nothing there. He bounces
Paterno
off,
got down for a loss.
Goes outside and is thrown down for a loss on the play. Back at the 10. Let's see who made the tackle.
Harris with the
Justin
tackle.
Harris with the tackle. Justin Harris, a 6'3", 230-pound sophomore from Maywood Proviso East High School.
Loss of 2 on that play.
So it's second and goal from the 7. Adrian looking for a play from Coach Deer. There's some movement.
Penalty flag on the play.
Penalty markers down. Let's see what the call is here. The referees confer.
Before the snap, false start. Number 85 on the offense. 5 yards from the previous stop. Repeat second down.
Jack Shanahan, the referee, calls the false start. 5-yard pickoff. 5-yard walk-off. Second goal from the 14-yard line. 1:46 remaining in the half. Adrian would like nothing better than to put this one in, but the Blue Jay defense has stiffened. And trying to thwart this attempt for a score. Raymond running up the middle.
Raymond, the ball carrier.
Gets down inside the 5. We went to the middle, then went outside.
Agbenya there for the Blue Jays.
Gets to about the
along with Scott.
4. Pick up 10 yards. Third and goal from about the 4. So Raymond looking for the play from Coach Jim Deere on the side over there. Jim Deere, the coach at Adrian, an 89 graduate at Adrian. The clock continues to wind down. 1 minute remaining in the half, and a timeout is taken.
Timeout. Adrian, the first of the half. Please set the clock.
A timeout on the field.
59.
We've got
seconds.
Seven. Elmhurst digging in their heels. Paterno is with quarterback Raymond back there. Raymond rolling left, throwing left. Oh! Overthrows his intended receiver. And his receiver was in fact open, but just couldn't get it to him. Incomplete.
Comes out for Adrian.
So Adrian will kick a field goal here. Just a little bit too much on that pass intended for Tyler Poyer.
Millie to attempt the field goal.
And so Millie will attempt the field goal for Adrian out of the hold of Ashman. Long snapper is Nick MacArthur.
Kick is up.
Kick is up.
And
it's good.
54.4
seconds remaining in the first half.
Adrian, three.
Our score from Langhorst, Elmhurst 7, and Adrian 3. All right, we're ready to restart the game.
Pollock back deep.
Millie will kick off.
Along with Burnett for the Blue Jays.
And Pollock and Burnett back for the Blue Jays to return this kick. 54.4 seconds remaining, and this is the first half.
Millie's kick in the air.
Short kick. It's a pop-up. And it is like a onside kick.
Adrian
in that
recovers
it's a live
kick.
Ball. And Adrian recovers. Ooh, special teams miscue by the Blue Jays.
Allen
cost them.
Gets credit for covering that.
Allen recovered the ball for the Bulldogs. And so now Adrian's in business. First down and 10 yards to go. The ball marked. Let's see where they mark it. They're placing the ball down as we speak. Call it the 33-yard line. First and 10 from the 33. Well, that pop-up type kick caught the Blue Jay special teams off guard, the kickoff return team. So the Bulldogs back in business with 52 seconds remaining. Raymond.
Field.
flanked by Paterno. They fake the handoff. Miranda, they fumble the turtle, handoff. And Raymond came up with it, but there's a loss on the play back to the 31. So it's going to be second down and 13 with a timeout on the clock with 42 seconds remaining. Our score, Elmhurst 7, Adrian nothing.
Please put 4, thank you.
We're back, second and 14 for the Bulldogs at the Blue Jay 32. Raymond looking downfield, throwing downfield.
Raymond's pass complete on the far side. Caught by Sessler.
It's caught by Sessler over there, Raymond's pass
West
was.
West with the tackle.
West with the tackle. Let's see where they mark that football.
Short of the first down.
Around
Adrian.
The 20. So by the 12-yard pickup on the play. Short of the first down. It'll be third down and 2 yards to go. The ball at the 20-yard line. Twin receivers to the left, lone receiver right for the Bulldogs. And they give it to the
Paterno,
first back through.
The
Paterno. Paterno gets inside the 20 barely to maybe the 19-yard line.
Agbenya with the tackle for the Blue Jays.
And we've got another timeout.
32 seconds on the clock.
31.8 seconds remaining until the intermission. Elmhurst 7, Adrian 3. Fourth down and 1 for the Adrian Bulldogs from the Elmhurst 19-yard line. 32 seconds remaining in the first half. 7-3 Elmhurst. Raymond with Greer in the backfield. Raymond keeps it, picks his way forward.
Raymond, the ball carrier.
And he gets... Oh, inside the 20.
First down yardage.
Maybe
the
19.
Bulldogs.
And we're not sure if he got the first down or not. I've not seen the official. Oh, they stop.
Elmhurst ball goes over on downs.
Holy smokes, it goes over on downs to Elmhurst. I wasn't sure. I thought maybe he had gotten it, but I learned a long time ago you wait for the official before you render a decision. And Jack Shanahan says it goes the other way. So great job by the Elmhurst defense. They had their backs up against the wall after that pop-up kick. That was a live ball that Adrian recovered. So now with 27 seconds remaining and a 7-3 lead, I look for Elmhurst to possibly take a knee. And that will do it. We think. And that is our halftime. Our score here at Langhorst Field on the campus of Elmhurst University, in this, the season over for opener for 2023, 7-3 Elmhurst. And for today's halftime entertainment, we're going to welcome featured twirler Nicoletta Bowick, if we pronounce that right. So it's 7-3 here at halftime as Elmhurst gets a touchdown early on in the football game. And then in the second quarter, about midway through, Adrian answers with a field goal. And so our score here at halftime, 7-3, Elmhurst. And, of course, the Blue Jays certainly looking forward to improving on last year's season, and they're well on their way to do that here. But in their way is a very formidable Adrian football team, as both defenses have played really, really well in this, the first half of action.
For today's
here
halftime entertainment, please welcome Elmhurst
Langhorst Field
twirler Nicoletta Bowick.
Again, this is Nicoletta, I mispronounced it, Nicoletta Bowick coming out to perform here at halftime.
For nearly 150 years, Elmhurst College prepared students for lives of meaning and success. Today, as Elmhurst University, we're carrying on that proud legacy. A beautiful campus just 30 minutes from downtown Chicago. Small classes where you'll get to know your professors. And top-ranked majors and graduate programs that will open the door to the career of your dreams. As we celebrate a new name for our institution in an ever-changing world, our values and spirit remain the same. Welcome to Elmhurst University.
You just might end up making the world a better place. But first, you have to discover who you are and what you can learn from others. To do that, you have to seek out teachers and mentors who will help you identify your goals and challenge you to go after them. Before you can do that, you have to find a community that welcomes and supports you. A place where you can learn. A place where you can thrive. Before you can do that, you must have motivation and desire to improve your mind, your soul, your circumstances. To ignite that desire, you must find your potential. We'll help you discover your potential once you discover us. Elmhurst University.
We know that going to college is a huge investment. You put your trust and time in Elmhurst University, and we do the same. You invest in us, and we invest in you.
Your story begins as we welcome you to Elmhurst University. From your first day of orientation, our focus is getting you acclimated to college life and making you a part of the Elmhurst community.
Definitely Elmhurst was the one that I fell in love with. Right when you stepped on campus, it was a nice environment. It just felt like home.
The goal of first year seminar is to make the transition from high school to college as smooth as possible. It's an instantaneous way to have a niche at Elmhurst.
A lot of times there's that doubt that I don't know if I can make it here. I don't know if I'm meant to be here. I feel it is our role as an institution to get those doubts out of their mind the second they are on this campus.
Once you've started classes, our responsibility is to support you both personally and academically.
Your faculty and your staff who are here and committed to your success are going to be walking with you on that journey, providing both the challenge and the support for you along that way.
I changed my major about 5 times, and so I really needed someone there to help me through it, help me pick out new classes, to help me make sure that I graduate on time.
So they support us academically, but they're also interested in our lives as a whole individual. For example, when I was applying for the Fulbright, they were more than willing and super supportive.
Along with supporting you, our job is to make sure you challenge yourself in order to make the most of your experience.
When the students, especially in computer science, go out into related fields, they're going to be confronted with adapting to new environments, new technologies, and we try to challenge them in the classroom to adapt, to learn how to learn.
I've had teachers go to me and say, like, I think you'd be interested in research. So they introduced me to some professors, and I've been doing research now for 3 semesters. It taught me a lot about myself, definitely, and about the way I adapt to different situations.
I think we all learn best when we're a little bit scared, a little bit on the edge. They really believe that the things that are beyond the typical, experiencing undergraduate research, studying abroad, having a quality internship, some of those things are going to be most memorable and meaningful and really impactful for them.
As your academic journey at Elmhurst comes to an end, our relationship reaches a crucial point as we launch you into the next phase of your life.
Elmhurst is a liberal arts college that aims at creating educated citizens, and that's not a process that just takes 4 years or 2 years. We're invested in these students. We give our kind of heart and soul to them while they're here, and so we care if they succeed once they leave.
When students go on to graduate and go on to live amazing lives and do things personally and professionally, their fingerprints are still all over this institution in a way that helped us to become a better sense of who we are and who we as an institution want to be in the world.
We don't at Elmhurst tell students what to think, but we try to teach them how to engage with their own values to become better citizens of this country, of this world.
And that makes me proud to be a part of the community of Elmhurst.
I'm confident in our graduates because I know we've prepared them both personally and professionally. We love to see them fly the nest and flourish.
My name is Michael. I'm a senior here. I study special education, and I'm a first-generation college student.
My name is Lauren Berryhill. I'm a junior, and I'm a music education major.
My name is Sarah Jean Dickey. I am a double major in mathematics and computer science with a minor in Spanish, and I'm a senior.
My name is Raniel Morales. I'm a freshman, and I'm a psychology major.
I transferred to Elmhurst because I liked the small class sizes, and I really value that professor-student relationship that I knew that I was going to get here.
When I was looking at other colleges, it just didn't feel like people cared and wanted you there the same way that when you came to Elmhurst. They just really wanted you to be there and to learn and grow, and I felt like I would be comfortable coming here, but also be pushed in so many ways to grow and become better.
I already knew some people who went here, and I'd visit a couple times just to hang out with them. I just really liked being around them and being here, And the campus itself is absolutely beautiful.
My sister did go to school here as well. I kind of already knew the campus a little bit, knew it was a great school. I'm glad I chose Elmhurst because it was probably the best place for me. And it was the best monetary decision as well.
When I first transferred, I live in apartments. But now I live in Stanger, and I really couldn't picture it any other way. Like, I love being on campus. There's just something about rolling out of bed and going to class that I love.
I started out in Schick my freshman year here. I moved to Niebuhr halfway through. I lived in Schick my sophomore year as well, and I've been living in an on-campus house on Myrtle for the past 2 years, and I love it there.
I've actually only lived in Cureton Hall all 3 years. I really could stay there my fourth year and be fine.
I love the community that it brought, that you were one room away from your friends, you were eating dinner on campus together almost every night, and just that there were different opportunities within the residence hall.
A day in the life is pretty hectic. Most music ed majors, their classes are in the mornings and then their ensembles are in the afternoon. So I'm pretty much boom, 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 thing to thing to thing.
I'm a morning person, so whether I have class in the morning or not, I like to wake up a little bit on the earlier side.
So I'd wake up at 5:30, practice, eat breakfast quickly, go to my 9 a.m.
Probably have class till around noon. And depending on the day, I'll probably head out to the local middle school to take some time with my students there, go to the library to do some homework, and then I also work at the library.
Get out of class, go home, change, go directly to work.
I'll usually have work later in the afternoon, and then eat dinner, maybe do some more homework, watch a movie.
Get a dinner or some snacks at the Roost, and then head back to my dorm to do some homework and head to bed.
Usually I spend time with my friends at night, and that's when I get to catch up on what's going on.
My favorite place on campus is on the third floor of the education department. It's the best place to study with the best view.
I have two favorite places on campus. One is my house, but I also love the conference room in Daniels.
My favorite place would be the cafeteria.
Sitting in Founders, I love to sit at one of those tables and do homework. You can be in there to have fun, you can be in there to study, and the vibe can be whatever you want it to be.
Out of the four classes that I took this past semester, my favorite class was acting. The professor was Dr. Tony Noyce. He is such a character. He's so awesome to be around. It was such a fun experience.
And my favorite class was probably linear algebra with Dr. Crawford. It was part theory and part computation, which I really liked how it pulled those two concepts together. I mean, Dr. Crawford is just an amazing teacher. I've had her almost every semester since I've been here.
Post-colonial theory with Dr. Janice Lively, and that class had me thinking about it like all day.
Music theory class, which is probably an interesting choice because it was at 8 a.m. every single day my freshman year, both semesters, which no one likes 8 a.m.s in college. My professor, Mr. Streeter, is incredible, and my class became more of a community than anything. It was a really nice way to come into college, and honestly, my best friends came out of that class.
One of my favorite activities is the honors program. I've been involved with it all 4 years that I've been on campus here. I'm also involved in Alpha Phi Omega here on campus. You do a lot of service in the community. You get to build relationships with people in the organization, and you get to do a lot of leadership activities.
I've been involved in lots of student groups on campus, all the choral ensembles, the vocal ensembles, and I loved being in late night blues, vocal jazz. We just had a lot of fun and really bonded with each other. I'm also a member of Phi Mu. It's a really fun way to like meet people, but also to give back to others that need it.
My favorite organizations that I've been a part of is definitely the Black Student Union, because I really like what they're doing for the campus overall and the social justice issues that they're pursuing on campus.
I'm pretty much just involved with running. I'm really proud to be a Blue Jay because it's an amazing community. Blue also looks really nice when we're running, so it's awesome.
Love being a student ambassador in the Office of Admissions. It's really great because I get to give tours to all these potential students, whether they're first years or transfers.
I'm a CA for the ELSA students, which basically means that I live in the dorms that they also live in to provide any like extra support that they might need. And I'm really proud to be part of this program, especially because it's like one of the few in the country. And it's awesome because I work with students with disabilities in like classrooms, and they always ask me, oh, can I go to Elmhurst? And like, I can say confidently, yes, you can go to Elmhurst.
When I cross the stage at graduation, I'll be most proud of all the research that I've done. I didn't come into college with the intention to do that. I fell in love with the idea of research and the process of doing research.
It's just incredible to look back and think that Elmhurst has done so much for me already, and I think that's what I'll be most proud of, to think just who I've become and who I want to be still.
I think what I would remember most fondly are obviously my friends that I've made.
Making memories with those friends and really interesting places that normally wouldn't be so exciting, but they are, because you love each other and you get to know each other so well.
between the professors and the friends that I've made, I think that that will stay with me the rest of my life.
People who give back to Elmhurst, you're not only helping me, you're helping my family grow as well. Me graduating college and being the first one to graduate means that hopefully others in my family, like my nephews and nieces, can see that and want to come to a school like Elmhurst.
So when you give money to Elmhurst, you're giving these students like the experience of a lifetime and the ability to become who they're meant to be.
Thank you for giving us the opportunity to change our lives.
Defend yourselves. Make yourselves known. Always.
Bob Brunel back with you here at Langhorst Field on the campus of Elmhurst University, where it's halftime and the Elmhurst Blue Jays lead the Adrian Bulldogs by a score of 7-3. Let's take a look at some statistics for you here at halftime. First of all, the team stats. First downs, the Adrian Bulldogs have picked up a total of 7 first downs and 3 for Elmhurst. Rushing yards net for Adrian, 24 carries for 113 yards. For Elmhurst, 17 carries for 22 yards. Passing for Adrian, Brady Raymond is 4 of 6 with one of interception, while Elmhurst quarterback Andre Acosta is 6 of 9. So total offensive plays and yardage, 30 for Adrian for 141 yards, 26 for Elmhurst for a total of 30 yards. Individually rushing for Elmhurst, Samson Zander has 5 carries for a total of 12 yards, an average of 2.4. Aiden Pollock, 7 carries and a total of 8 yards, carry of average of 1.1 for Adrian. Paterno, 12 carries for 41 yards, 3.4 yard average. Anthony Greer carried the ball 4 times for a total of 39 yards, a 9.8 average. Passing, Raymond, 4 of 6, as we alluded to. His longest was 12. Acosta, 6 of 9. His longest was 10. Receiving yards, Cole Seslar leads the way for Adrian. He has a total of 2 catches for 18 yards, while Jacob Cockrell has 2 catches for a total of 8 yards. Scoring, first quarter, Elmhurst scores Gable with that 8 for that interception, and then Adrian scored on that field goal, and our score is 7-3. We're ready to get this second half underway, and kicking off for the Blue Jays is McCarville. And
line drive kick. Pipkins on the return.
And returning it is Pipkins for Adrian.
Down at about the 26
and he gets out to the 26-yard line, where it will be first down and 10 yards to go for Adrian. So, again, we expect to see Brady Raymond as the quarterback for the Bulldogs. And Paterno has been the running back. We expect to see him as well. Receivers either side. Paterno tries left tackle, finds a little bit of running room. 33-yard line. Pickup of about 6 yards.
Gain of 6 on the play.
Second down and about 4 yards to go will be the call for Adrian from the 33-yard line. Again, Adrian runs out of the pistol offense, or the shotgun, if you will, and they throw out in the flat this time. Raymond does. And he's got a receiver who makes the catch out there and advances the ball out across the 42-yard line. Making the tackle out, or making the catch out there, was Jewell. And good enough for the first down. First down, 10 yards to go. The ball at the 42 for the Bulldogs. Brady gives to Greer, and Greer tries to skirt the right end, but there's nothing there. Whatever hole may have been there closed early on in the sequence. Second down and 10. Again, our score 7-3 Elmhurst as we begin this, the third quarter. Elmhurst looking for a home win to open up their season. Of course, Adrian looking to do the same as well, being the road team from Southern Michigan. Greer on a delay. He finds a little bit on the left side, but not much, as he's met, wrapped up, and thrown back by Gable. I'm going to say they're going to give him a little forward progress.
And it's 3 on the play.
Up to the 45-yard line, which would translate into a gain of 3. Third down and 7 to go for the Bulldogs of Adrian. Twin receivers left side. We've got a single receiver out to the right. Brady finds a man out in the flat. Paterno makes the grab.
Pass complete to
So they get across the 45 all the way out to the midfield stripe. They're going to be right at the midfield stripe. Pickup of about five. Fourth and seven will be the Adrian call here. Adrian shuffling players in and out. Trying to decide whether or not, correction, we said fourth and seven, it's fourth and two. They're going to go for the first down. Raymond hands off to Paterno, and he's met and dropped. The defense rises to the occasion again, and the ball goes over on downs to the Blue Jays.
West with the tackle.
West with the tackle, first down and 10 yards to go. Actually, there was a loss of about a yard on that play, so the Blue Jay offense will start this drive just inside Bulldog territory at the 49. Pollock comes out as the running back for the Elmhurst quarterback, Anthony Acosta. Twin receivers are split out to the right, a slot right side. Acosta out of the pistol. Hands off to Pollock. They do no, it fake to Pollock. Pass downfield is made. Downfield at the 35. Penalty flag down. The reception was made on the play by McCarville for Elmhurst. Let's see what we've got here. Got about a 15-yard pickup on the play. Personal foul, face mask against Adrian.
15 yards from the previous.
That's the big one when it's a personal foul, so a 15-yard walk-off. And it's going to be Blue Jay football down at the 19-yard line of Adrian. And an excellent opportunity here for the Blue Jays. So they send Cockrell out wide to the left. Holtke is in the slot left side. Pollock is behind the quarterback, Acosta. Audrey out of the pistol, fakes it to Pollock, comes back, throws right. He's got the receiver. I think that's Desmore.
Complete to Anderson, knocked out of bounds.
Correction.
By Pipkins.
Emerson, Pipkins with the tackle. Ball down to about the 10. A 9 or 10 yard pickup. It's going to be second and short. The ball just outside the 10. We're in the red zone, but we're not in a goal to goal situation as yet. We've got trips out to the left. Costa sidesteps a defender, and then he's brought down in the backfield.
A loss
on the play back to the 15.
Bidwell there for the Bulldogs.
Bidwell there for the Adrian Ball Club defensively. So the ball resting squarely on the Adrian 15-yard line. We're looking at third down and two. We've got Desmore in the slot. Excuse me, Anderson in the slot to the right. Excuse me. Acosta out here to Pollock in the flat. He spins away.
It's
thrown inside the five, out of bounds at the four. Pick up on the play from the 15 down to about the 4. That's called 11 yards. First and goal, Blue Jays, from about the 4-yard line. An excellent opportunity here for Elmhurst. We've got Deuce back field. Pollock is the tail of the tandem. He carries the ball
Pollock
into the stack.
Carrier.
He might have got a yard. a host of tacklers there defensively for the Bulldogs. They're going to give the tackle to Bulldog defender Randall Broom. Second down and goal. The ball about the 4. Again, we've got the Deuce backfield. Hand off to Pollock. He tries the left side. He's in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Blue Jays. 8:21 remaining in the third quarter. And the Blue Jays increase the score to 13-3. Nice run left side as Pollock negotiated that left side and found the end zone for the touchdown. As we await the extra point, placement down.
Kick is up. And good.
And it's good.
Ricardo
with the kick. With 8 minutes, 21 seconds remaining in the third quarter, our score, Elmhurst finds themselves with a 13 to make that 14-3 lead. To restart the game, McCarville has the ball teed up at the Blue Jay 35-yard line.
Kick in the air.
Kick is up.
Pritkins
with the return about the 5-yard line, the 10, the 15, and the 20. Bounces out across the 30, and they'll mark it at the 34-yard line, where it will be Adrian football, first down and 10 yards to go, going from east to west here at Elmhurst.
Adrian to start first and 10 at their
34-yard line. So now the Bulldogs need to see what they can do to get back in this one. A two-score affair right now at 14-3. Raymond out of the pistol. Paterno right up the gut. Nothing fancy. A couple little sidesteps. Gets up 38-yard line. Give him a gain of 4.
Scott with the tackle
for the Blue Jays. Second down, let's call it 6 yards to go for the Bulldog first down as they are working from their own 43.
Gain of 4 on that play.
Twin receivers deployed to the right for Adrian. One to the left for the Bulldogs as well. And we've got Greer carrying the football. Gets up to the 40-yard line.
Up there for the Blue Jays along with Gable on the stop.
Tackle made by Fetro. Let's see. Short pickup on the play. We're looking down at 3rd and 3 now from the Adrian 40 for the Bulldogs. Raymond fakes to Greer, rolls left, throws a quickie left, and the catch is made by Poirier.
Caught by Poirier. Scott with the tackle.
Scott with the tackle.
For Adrian. Pollock going back deep for Elmhurst.
Not enough for the first down, so Adrian will have to boot it away. Millie will kick it away. Returning for the Blue Jays, this is Pollock.
Pollock with the fair catch.
Pollock at the 16.
Blue Jays to start 17.
First down and 10 yards to go line. From that 17-yard line. 6:12 remaining third quarter. Elmhurst 14, Adrian 3. So let's see what the Blue Jays have in their bag of tricks here offensively for this drive. Costa, his running back will be Pollock. Twin receivers deployed to either side this time. Acosta in the pistol, fakes the run. Oh, throws on the flat.
Is incomplete.
Intended out here for Masco.
Broken up by Smith.
Smith almost broke it up and almost made an interception. He was Johnny on the spot on that play. Good job defensively for him. Incomplete forward pass, second down and 10. Burnett checks into the Blue Jay lineup. This time the Blue Jays deploy three to the left, trips to the left, lone receiver right. Acosta, Xander. Xander with a run right up the middle. Found a little running room there across the 20 to 21-yard line. Possibly the 22.
Gain of three.
Give him a gain of three. We're looking at third down.
Room with the tackle.
Third down and about six. Third and six at the 22 is the call. Big third down play here for the Blue Jays with 5.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Costa looking to throw. He has a man over the middle. He's got his man over the middle. He catches the ball, goes to the outside, far side a little bit, and then runs it up to the 50-yard line. That was Holtke. Holtke gets it up to the 48-yard line. 26-yard pickup on the play for the first down. First down, 10 yards to go from the 48 for the Blue Jays. Nice pass over the middle from Acosta to Holtke. First down, 10 yards to go is the call. Again, from that pistol offense. Fake. Acosta still has it. Downfield. Oh, it's intercepted. Was he inbounds? No, he wasn't. Just out of bounds.
Bell nearly had an interception for Adrian.
Ashman almost had the interception there. He made the catch, but he was out of bounds, so second down and 10, a break for the Blue Jays. Acosta had a little pressure early. He was able to elude that pressure, but didn't see that defender underneath Ashman who came up and got in the way. It's called second and 10 from the 47 for the Blue Jays. This is Pollock.
Pollock
negotiating the 50-yard line. He is able to negotiate and achieve it and get into Adrian territory, the 47. Yeah, 48. So we'll give him, what, five on the play. We're looking at about third down and let's call it six at the 48. So we've got Cockrell wide to the left. Twin receivers to the right. Holtke is one of them. And the other one is McCarville.
Pollock, the ball carrier.
Pollock is the ball carrier up the middle.
And with the tackle.
46. Give him two.
Gain of two on the play.
It's called fourth down and four. So it's fourth and four from the 46 for Elmhurst. Twin receivers to the right. We've got a lone receiver left. We've got a slot left as well. Acosta over the middle. He's got the receiver.
Catch is complete. Caught by Anderson.
Anderson has the catch at the 41. Pick up a five. First down and 10 yards to go. Tackle made on the play by Ashman for Adrian. First down, 10 yards to go, Blue Jays, and they are on the drive again. On the move. Trips to the right. One running back. Acosta drops back, looks downfield. Now he's going to tuck it. He's going to run with it. Oh, he gets hit hard by Ashman at the 35.
Met by Ashman.
It's called a 36. Pick up a five on the play. It'll be second down and five.
71 on the offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. First down.
Got a holding call on the offense, unfortunately. So we've got first down, let's call it 20 yards to go. Let's call it the 49-yard line of Elmhurst. So they're back in their own territory. Hopefully momentarily if you're a Blue Jay fan. Acosta looks left and right. He's flanked by Pollock to his right. Trips to the right, a lone receiver left. Over the middle, he's got his man. 45, almost the 40. Cockrell makes the catch.
First down yardage.
Tackle by McCray, the safety. 41.
Correction, 10 yards to go.
So pickup of about 10 on the play. Second down, let's call it 10 yards to go. The ball marked at the Adrian 41. Burnett in as a running back for the Blue Jays this play. He shifts from left to right flank. Takes the handoff, goes from right to left. Ooh, lost his footing.
And is
thrown down.
Brought down for a loss.
In the backfield.
Loss of three on the play.
They're going to say a loss of about 3 yards. McCray on the tackle. Blue Jays left with a third and 13.
Bidwell gets credit for that tackle for the Bulldogs.
Also Bidwell in on the stop for Adrian. Third and 13. The ball's on the Adrian 44. Burnett takes the handoff up the middle.
The ball carrier.
Not much there. He's going to lose a yard.
There first for the Bulldogs. No gain on the play.
In there first for the Bulldogs was Riker Bidwell.
That's the end of the third quarter.
6'2", 240, a sophomore. At the end of three quarters from Langhorst Field on the campus of Elmhurst. Our score, Elmhurst 14, Adrian 3.
You just might end up making the world a better place. But first, you have to discover who you are and what you can learn from others. To do that, you have to seek out teachers and mentors who will help you identify your goals and challenge you to go after them. Before you can do that, you have to find a community that welcomes and supports you. A place where you can learn. A place where you can thrive. Before you can do that, you must have motivation and desire to improve your mind, your soul, your circumstances. To ignite that desire, you must find your potential. We'll help you discover your potential once you discover us. Elmhurst University.
We start the fourth quarter 14 to 3 on this Labor Day weekend 2023. Where did that summer go? I think we say that every year, don't we? Fourth and 13 for Elmhurst. Blue Jays are going to kick it away. Not a long kick, down to about the 20-yard line.
Well, it's run down on the 20-yard line.
Where the Bulldogs will have the ball, first down and 10 yards to go. And they need a score to get back in this one. Elmhurst has asserted themselves and shown really well here in this season opener. Again, both defenses have played rather well, especially the Elmhurst defense here this afternoon. Raymond rolling right, throwing right with his left hand, and he gets it out
by Gable
to his wideout tight end, Poyer. Gable makes the tackle. Let's see. About a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6, let's call it, on the play. Twin receivers left, one receiver deployed to the right. Raymond throws it out here quickly, and he has the receiver. Sesslar gets to the 30-yard line.
First down on that catch for Adrian.
First down. Tackle made on the play. Agbenya. First and 10 to go for the Bulldogs at their own 31-yard line. Raymond intended downfield. Knocked away.
Intended for Jewell.
Intended for Jewell.
Reeves with the coverage.
And the Rage with the coverage. No gain on the incompletion. Second down and 10. Ball on the Bulldog, let's call it 31-yard line. Raymond from the pistol. Throws out here, has his wide receiver once again. This is Reeves.
Sessler with the catch.
Sessler. Sessler with the catch. That's like his second one out of the last three plays. Up to the 40. Pickup of about 9, so it's third and a yard to go for the first down. Raymond. And the
Paterno, the ball carrier.
Back down, Paterno takes it. And gets the first down for the Bulldogs. First down and 10, Adrian. Ball at the 44-yard line. The Adrian 44. Raymond rolls left. Oh, and is he hit? Oh, my goodness. Out of nowhere, Masco, the inside linebacker, made the play, and a big loss on the play.
Masco with the tackle.
But after that big play by Masco, we've got a holding call against the defense. So it's going to go for naught.
Automatic
first down.
And the automatic first down as a result on the penalty marker. Oh, my goodness.
Please reset the clock to
what a big play by Masco.
0-3. Thank you.
13:30 left in the game, 13 and a half minutes. It's still 14-3, Blue Jays. A bone-rattling tackle by Masco. So here we go for the Bulldogs. Raymond looks downfield. He's got a man at the 25-yard line, busting free and making the catch. It's Kolaski.
West with the tackle.
West with the tackle. First and 10 at the 24. First and 10 for the Bulldogs from the Adrian 24-yard line. They're on the march now. They want to get a score here. Raymond, again, he has his man right away. The ball is fumbled. Is it recovered?
Pass is incomplete.
Pass is ruled incomplete to Seslar. The defender doing a great job of trying to strip the ball, was unable to be successful in that regard.
That was West with the coverage.
West with the coverage. Second down and 10 is the call. Ball remains at the 24-yard line of Adrian. Paterno flanks Raymond to the left in the pistol. Fade pattern to the end zone, incomplete. Intended down there for Kolaski. Coverage two. The corner back there. Is it West, maybe? Third and 10. The ball at the Elmhurst 22. So Adrian's going to try once again. They've got trips to the left, and they are going to take a timeout. 12:19 remaining in the football game. Our score, Elmhurst 14, Adrian 3. What's that? Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm sorry. All right, welcome back. Third and 10 from the 24 for Adrian. The Elmhurst 24. 12:19 remaining. Raymond running right. He's got a little bit of a room on this right side.
Raymond, the ball carrier.
Gets down around the 12. 11 and a half or 12. Gain of 12 on the play. First down. First down.
Laylighter gets credit for knocking Raymond out of bounds.
Raymond rolls left, looking left. Oh, it's intercepted.
Intercepted.
Oh, what a great job on the defense there for the Blue Jays. And could return it all the way to the house.
Penalty flag on the play.
And a penalty marker on the field at the Adrian 36-yard line. Intercepted by Connor DeVries, the free safety.
That was DeVries with the interception.
And he got it down, I don't know, around the 10-yard line. That's a guess on my behalf. But it's going to come back. So it will be Blue Jay ball. They will take the touchdown off the board. Oh, my goodness. That was exciting.
Block in the back. Number 9 on the return team. That will be enforced 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down, Elmhurst. After the play.
The bad news is they don't get the 6 points.
Adrian.
The good news is the Blue Jays get the football first down and 10 yards to go with the ball at about the 25-yard line, maybe the 26. So first and 10 from the 26.
Pollock, the ball carrier.
Pollock advances the football for the Blue Jays. Up to about the 26-yard line. Oh, no gain. Second down and 10.
No gain on the play.
10 minutes remaining in the football game. Our score remains Elmhurst 14, Adrian 3. Throwing out here in the near side, and it's intercepted. A pass intended for Holtke is intercepted on the play.
Tolbert with the interception.
By Tolbert. And so Adrian gets the ball back.
On that turnover.
First down and 10 yards to go on the interception. Ball will be marked at well, right at midfield. For the longest time, difficulty locating the ball, but it was blocked by the official. All right, Adrian with the ball. First down and 10 yards to go. Right at the midfield stripe. We've got a new quarterback in the game.
That's complete to Sessler. West with the tackle. Gain of 2 on the play.
Mark Lopez is the new quarterback. Mark is a freshman from Corpus Christi, Texas. Got a quick pass out to Sessler. Now throwing downfield intended for Sessler.
Intended for Sessler.
Incomplete down around the 10.
West with the coverage.
West with the coverage for Elmhurst. It'll be 3rd down and 8. 3rd down and 8 for the Bulldogs. Well, Lopez has an arm. He showed that in just his second play from scrimmage. Something tells me he's going to throw again. 3rd down and 8 from the 48. The Blue Jay 48. Lopez out here in the flat. He's got his man. And again, it's Cesslar.
This is complete to Cesslar.
Coverage and tackle by
fourth down,
Stewart.
Facing the Bulldogs.
Ball's at the 42-yard line. Fourth down, 8 from the 42.
Paterno
carries the ball
for Adrian
and gets the first down. First down and 10 yards to go. Adrian
Scott with the tackle.
In the hurry. Again, Cesslar makes the catch at the 35.
Reeves with the tackle.
Reeves with the tackle for Elmhurst.
Gain of 4 on the play.
4-yard gain. Second and 6. Adrian on the move here, trying to get a score. Throwing downfield, ball intended downfield for Ashman.
For Bonza,
rather. We got two number 8s in the ball game here. DeVries, the free safety on the coverage. Third down and 6. 8 minutes, 50 seconds remaining. Elmhurst leads 14-3. Twin receivers left. Twin receivers right. Paterno in the backfield. Lopez. Paterno makes the catch.
Brought out of bounds by the Masco.
Masco makes the play on the defense. 30-yard line. Yeah, let's call it the 30.
Fourth down.
Pick up a 4.
The Bulldogs.
Fourth down and about 4 to go for the Bulldogs. Clock continues to wind down in this 14-3 game. Elmhurst looking for their first win in a while. Let's see if they're successful here today. Lopez rolls right. Throws right.
Pass complete.
Short completion.
Poirier with the catch.
Poirier makes the catch.
Scott
made the tackle.
Ball goes over on downs to the Blue Jays.
Ball goes over on downs as the Bulldogs were not successful in recording the first down. So with 8:13 remaining and Elmhurst up, they get the football back. First and 10 from their own 30. Well, you know what? You can't get ahead of yourself, but and the Blue Jays got to continue their good play, but things are looking good. Handoff.
Pollock, the ball carrier.
Pollock, once again, the ball carrier, as he has been so many times here this afternoon.
Ashman with the tackle.
Ashman makes the tackle for the Bulldog defense. Pickup of 3. Let's call it second down and 7 yards to go. As we're under the 8-minute mark now. Elmhurst obviously in no hurry here. They want to work as much clock as they can. Shot clock. The play clock is on their side. Here we go, Twins to the right. I think we're going to run the football. Pollock wraps his arms securely around the ball and moves forward for a yard or 2. That will leave a
Smith with the tackle.
Third down situation after Smith made the tackle for Adrian.
Third and 7 for the Blue Jays.
Third and 7 will be the situation confronting Elmhurst quarterback Andre Acosta. The Blue Jays may be throwing a pass here to get the first down. Acosta rolls right after a fake. Throws downfield. He's got a receiver. 42. McCarvo eludes one tackler and finally gets the ball up to the 49-yard line before he's finally brought down.
Colbert with the tackle.
Max McCarvo with a nice reception. 33 to the 49. 16-yard pickup on the play. First down, 10 yards to go. That was a big first down for the Blue Jays. 6:15 and counting for the Blue Jays. Again, opening of the season here, Labor Day weekend, 2023. Twin receivers to the left. Pollock.
Pollock, the ball carrier.
He's tripped up at the line of scrimmage, but he falls forward.
Tripped up by Ashman.
47-yard line, so he picks up about
three.
Second down, and let's call it seven to go. 5.5 minutes remaining. Boy, would this be a big win for the Blue Jays. Big win for the ball club, not only the team, but for the program, and certainly for the coaching staff. Costa going downfield. Oh,
penalty
flags
flag
everywhere.
On the play. Pass is incomplete.
Defender for Adrian grabbed the intended receiver for the Blue Jays.
Pass interference. Defense number 7. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
So Pipkins.
For Henderson.
Gets the call against him as it was intended for Henderson for the Blue Jays. So we're going to move the ball down to the 33-yard line of Adrian. First down and 10 yards to go for the Blue Jays. Acosta. Again, the hand to Pollock. Pollock's wrapped up and thrown
carrier
down right at the 35-yard line.
Loss on the play.
Broom makes the tackle.
Broom with the tackle for the Bulldog.
He's had his share of tackles here this afternoon. Second down, 10 for Elmhurst. Working from the Bulldog 34-yard line. 4.5 minutes remaining. Acosta fakes to Pollock, throws downfield, and we've got another flag coming
pass
down.
Incomplete.
Pass
intended for Klingler.
Klingler. Downfield. He couldn't get near it because he was interfered with.
Ineligible downfield player. On the offense, number 78.
Oh.
5 yards from the previous spot. Still second up.
Well, it's an eligible receiver downfield.
The penalty is declined. Third down.
As opposed to pass interference, which we all thought might have been the case. Javon Manuel is downfield a little bit too far. The penalty is declined. So it's third down from the Adrian 34. Third and 11.
Acosta
faked the ball and then to Pollock and then just ran right up the middle.
Petro with the tackle.
Down to the 25. 9-yard pickup.
9-yard gain on that run for Acosta. Fourth and two for
fourth
the Blue Jays.
And about two for the Blue Jays still after that 9-yard pickup. 3:50 and counting remaining. 14-3 Elmhurst. Well, it looks like the Blue Jays are going, in fact, pick up their first win of the season. And we've got a pile at the 25.
Pollock was
Adrian
the
says the ball is loose. And it's Adrian Ball. So the defense gets a turnover. And it'll be Adrian Ball, first down and 10 yards to go. They'll start from their own 25 with 3:26 remaining. So let's go.
Adrian, first and 10 from their 25.
Blue Jays go on the defense. Lopez continues as the quarterback. He's going to be sacked.
The
ball's popped up.
The Blue Jays.
And Elmhurst has recovered.
That was Ed Daniel with the pressure on Lopez.
Nice play there. Who got that? Who got the ball? Eight. Covered by Gable. So the Blue Jays get the ball back. First and 10 now for the Blue Jays, working from the Bulldog 23 with 3:20 remaining. New running back in, Zach Norman for the Blue Jays.
Norman, the ball carrier.
Norman gets across the 20 barely. Let's call it the 20. Groom with another tackle. And we've got a timeout. 3:12 remaining, our score. Elmhurst 14, Adrian 3. If I get my act together here. Welcome back to Langhorst Field on the campus of Elmhurst University. The Blue Jays are in a position to get their first victory of the season. They lead it 14-3 with 3:12 remaining, and they've got the ball first and 10 on their own 20. And we've got some movement.
Penalty on the play.
Flag down.
False start.
Well, they're prolonging the inevitable here.
Previous spot, still second down.
Come on! I don't think it's too premature to say it's all over but the shouting. But we still have 3 minutes and 12 seconds within which to play. So here goes the Blue Jays. First down, 10 yards to go. Once again, the give to Zach Norman. Gets his second carry of the game.
Smith with the tackle.
Their third and final half.
He advances the ball down to about the 23. Pickup of a couple. Again, our score, Elmhurst 14. Adrian 3. As we return to Elmhurst University, it's Elmhurst football, and Zach Norman, the ball carrier once again, advances the ball from the 23 down to around the 20. Yeah, it's right on the 20. Pickup of three. Tackle made on the play. Bell gained gained a three. So that makes it second and seven. Now we're down to five on the play clock, and Elmhurst is going to take a timeout. So with a timeout on the field, our score, Elmhurst 14, Adrian 3.
Clock operator, please reset the clock to 2:22. 2:22. Thank you.
Welcome back to Elmhurst. Also, welcome back to the longest, maybe last 5 minutes of a football game, especially on a warm afternoon here at Langhorst Field. Fourth and seven. Costa's going to throw it. A fade over to the far side, incomplete. So the ball goes over on downs. To Adrian.
Clock operator, please reset the clock to 2:16.
So we've got 2 minutes and 16 seconds remaining before the Blue Jays get their initial victory of the season. In a hard-fought football game here this afternoon. What's great about the football season is the weather has many sides from August until November, December, if you get bowl consideration. And today is the warm end of the spectrum. Oh! Snap is bobbled. Pass thrown incomplete. Raymond had all kind of difficulty getting the handle on that one. It's intended for Kolaski out there. Again, incomplete. Second down and seven. No, it's got to be second and 10. From the 20. Raymond throws out in the flat. He's got a receiver out there. Kolaski makes that catch. And is able to get a first down for the Bulldogs up around the 33-yard line. Pickup of about 13. Tackle made by Carrillo. First and 10 from the 33. And Raymond carries the ball this time. Gets a couple.
Gable with the
tackle for the Blue Jays.
Gain of two on the play.
Raymond now throws down the field. Had a player there, but he overthrew him a little bit. Kolaski was the intended receiver. So Elmhurst picking up the first ever victory and in the first ever meeting of these two schools. Adrian with the ball at their own 35 now. Third and 8 will be the call here. Raymond bobbles the snap, loses the snap on the turf, and it's recovered by Elmhurst. Gooden caused the fumble for the Blue Jays. So, the tale of the turnovers here today. Ball goes back to the Blue Jays. And this one has been sealed. They've got to run some clock, and this one will be over. A good opening day victory for the Elmhurst Blue Jays under first-year head coach Mike Murray.
Acosta takes a knee.
Acosta takes one knee. I would say maybe two more, and that should do it. So the Blue Jays get their first victory in over a year. And great effort down here today by the Blue Jays. Good stout defense. The defense has really played well and caused a good number of turnovers.
Acosta takes another knee.
Took another knee. And that should just about do it. All right, so our final score here this afternoon. The Elmhurst Blue Jays 14 and the Adrian Bulldogs 3 as Adrian gets the opening round victory here this afternoon in a very hard fought game by the Blue Jays. And again, the defense rose to the occasion. Several turnovers worked into their favor and helped them in this victory here today against Adrian. Again, first time meeting between these two fine schools.
Augustana, that is a 6 p.m. game time. Thanks for joining us here at Langhorne.
So now the Elmhurst Ball Club will take their 1-0 record to Augustana on September 16th. Okay. So good news here from Langhorst Field this afternoon, and kudos to everybody involved, and just a big win for the program. So for a lot of people here, want to thank Glenn Liljeburg and Ashley Liljeburg with their assistance here today. Also want to thank Jack Hill and, of course, the Sports Information Director, Matt Huffy, for everything here today. Good news from Langhorst Field on the campus of Elmhurst University. Our final score, Elmhurst 14 and Adrian 3. For Bob Brunel, thanks for listening and watching. Have a great Labor Day weekend.